Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In today's class, let us discuss how to do the auxiliary view of a given solid. Here the given solid is hexagonal pyramid. Okay, as we know, in the hexagonal pyramid the base is hexagon. Okay, all sides has equal length, and here this base is connected with the apex. We are taking apex is O1 and O is center of this hexagon. Let us take the given data. A hexagonal pyramid of base side 30 mm. As I told, this is the base. Base side is 3 cm. As we know, all the six sides has same length, that is 3 cm. And axis 70 mm. Axis means here the distance between center of this hexagon to apex. This distance is called axis, or we can call it as height of the pyramid. It is 70 mm. Here the line joining center to this apex is called axis. Okay, this axis line we are doing with two big lines with a dot. It is resting on its base on the HP. HP means horizontal plane. So this base is on the, this is the base of the pyramid. It is on the horizontal plane. Okay, consider this is the horizontal plane. Next data is with a side of base parallel to the VP. So take any one of the side, it is parallel to the vertical plane. Here I am taking one pyramid. Okay, this is one of the base side. It is parallel to the vertical plane means, let us take this is the vertical plane, and this base is parallel to this vertical plane, means the distance between these two is constant. Okay, now after that, the position of the hexagon what we are taking, it is correct. Okay, and if we stop, draw its projections. We need to do the projections, that is front view of the pyramid and top view of the pyramid. Okay, project an auxiliary top view. We need to do the auxiliary top view on a plane inclined at 30 degrees to the reference line. So for doing the auxiliary views, we are creating one plane, okay, one new reference line. Okay, that plane is tilting 30 degrees. Initially we will do the projections of this, after that we will do the auxiliary view. Let us do these projections of this pyramid in this position. For it, as we know, we are doing one reference line. It is called XY line of some length. In it we are doing the top view below this XY line. Top view means from the top we have to see this pyramid. From the top view we can see this hexagon, okay, base of the hexagon, and all the slant edges meeting at this center. Okay, so below the XY line we will see the top view. So top view is coming like this. Okay, roughly doing here. Okay, this is the top view. Here this side is parallel to the vertical plane like this. Okay, and here both apex and center are coming at the same place, O, O1. Okay, this is the top view. So front view means, so this is the top view. Above the top view, above the XY line, so this is the top view. After top view, above this XY line, we have to do the front view. Okay, in the front view, we have to see in this direction. We can see the pyramid in the form of triangular shape. Okay, so for getting it, we need to do the projections. Okay, we can see the entire height of the pyramid. How much it is? 70 mm. Okay, so above XY line, take 7 cm line. And we can see the triangular faces. So this is the front view, this is the top view. Let us do this front view and top view by using the instruments. First do the XY line of some length. Mark X, Y. So here this gap is not given from reference line to hexagon. Just do one line of 3 cm after some gap. Here take this is the reference line. After some gap, here do the 3 cm line. Okay, here how to do the hexagon? We did this line. Okay, here we are using the outer angle formula. If you are taking this angle, it is the outer angle. For doing any polygon, we are using this formula. So the formula is 360 by n, where n is number of sides of the polygon. Here it is hexagon, take 6. So outer angle is 60 degrees. So here also outer angle is 60. At all the corners, this angle is 60 degrees. And this side also, this angle is 60 degrees. Okay, here after doing this line, take here 60 degrees one line. So in this direction, take 3 cm. So here also take 60 degrees. In this direction, take 3 cm. Now after that, in this direction take 60 degrees. Here also take 60 degrees. So in this direction 3 cm, and this is the closing side. Check whether it is 3 cm or not. So it is exactly 3 cm. Join these two ends. Now this is the top view. After that, find out the center. How to find center? This is symmetrical about horizontal axis as well as vertical axis. For this type of polygons, join opposite ends. Okay, the intersection point is the center. So this is the center of this base. As we know, both center and the apex. Okay, let us take apex is O1. Both are coming at the same point. Okay, in the top view. So mark apex also O, O1. Mark the corners for top view. In small letters we are marking small a, small b, small c, d, e, f. So this is a top view. We need to do the front view. For doing the front view, we have to do the projectile lines from all the points. Projectile lines means thin lines. These thin lines should be perpendicular to this xy line. So these lines are projectile lines. These are thin lines and also perpendicular to the xy line. Okay. And here mark the front view points. For front view, we are taking the same point, A point, and we are marking dash. Okay. Here B and F are coming on the same line. Here B dash, F dash, and C dash, E dash, here D dash. So at the center also, axis line is passing. Take this is a reference line. At the center also do the axis line. As we know, axis line is two big lines with a dot up to this. Here mark the base. For base we are taking O. So in the front view we are marking O dash. Okay. As we know, in the front view, okay, if you see from this side, we can see the entire height of the pyramid. How much height it is? 70 mm. So 7 cm. So from this point take 7 cm vertical line. So mark the end point. So do the axis line. Two big lines with a dot. Mark the apex. For apex we are giving O1. So in the front view O1 dash. Now after that, join all these points with the apex. Those are the slant edges. This is the front view, this is the top view. These two views we are calling projections of this pyramid. Okay, here we have to draw its projections. We have completed this part. Here one more question is there. Project an axillary top view on a plane inclined at 30 degrees to the reference line. Here we are taking one plane which is tilting 30 degrees to the reference line. Okay, which is the reference line here? XY is the reference line. With this line, we have to take one plane, okay, which is tilting 30 degrees to XY. Okay, just extend this line. If you are doing the plane here, it is crossing this front view. That's why extend this line. Take one 30 degrees one plane, okay, at some distance. Okay, so here extend this side. Take any one of the point here. Take 30 degrees at this point. If you are taking 30 here, this plane will cross this front view. That's why take one more point at some distance from this diagram. At this point I will take 30 degrees. Here I am taking 30. So I will join this point to this point and check whether it is going outside the diagram or not. So this line will not touch the front view. That's why take the plane. Plane means here we are taking one line, okay, in that direction. So this is the new reference line. So here I am taking the parallel line at O dash. Okay, so keep the scale coincide with this line, and I will shift this line from this position to O1 dash. Okay. Instead of X1, Y1, so at this place I will do X1, Y1. I will remove this previous line. Okay, this previous line is tilting 30 degrees. Okay, and this line is also tilting 30 degrees because these two are the parallel lines. So this is the new reference line which is passing through the apex. Why I am taking this line instead of the previous line is here from all these points we have to do the projector lines. Okay, so this projector line should be perpendicular to this line. Just for taking the perpendicular line, I took the line at this point. Okay, these projector lines are perpendicular to the reference line. Okay, here this is a new reference line. Now do the projector line perpendicular to this line. Okay, so initially take apex, take 90 degrees. Okay, so in this direction do the projector line. Okay, just for taking the 90 degrees I took the reference line passing through the apex. Okay, for getting this line easily. And from all these points also do the projector lines. Take this is the reference line. From A dash also do the projector line. From B and F. And from center of this base. And C and E. And then from D also. Okay. This is the axillary plane above which we will do the axillary top view. Okay, here we have to do the axillary top view. We will get the axillary top view here. For getting the top view, whatever top view is here, take all these points, okay, here in this area. Now from the reference line, take a distance on this projector line by using compass. Take this a distance, okay, on the projector line from reference line. Mark the same radius on the a projector line from the new reference line. Take this intersection point of A and new reference line is the center. Mark the point A here. Okay, instead of A, I am giving A1. After A, mark B point. Okay. Marking B, take B projector line from this reference line. So take this point is intersection point. Take the B distance. Okay, on this projector line. Now take the same radius on the B projector line. Okay, from this reference line, take this point is the center, mark B here. Instead of B, mark B1. After marking B, mark C. Okay, take this distance from the reference line. Okay, from the reference line on C projector line, take C point distance. Okay, mark this distance on the C projector line from the new reference line. Take this intersection point is the center. Mark C here. So take C1. After marking C, mark D point. Take on the D projector line from this reference line. Take this distance. Okay. Now on the D projector line from this reference line, take this point as center. Mark D point. This is D1. After marking D, mark E. After marking E, take on the E projector line from this reference line. Take this point as a center. Take this distance, E distance, on the E projector line from this reference line. Mark on the same projector line. Take this point is E1. Okay, after E, mark F. Okay, take on the F projector line from a reference line. Take this distance. Okay, on F projector line from this reference line, mark the distance. It is F1. Okay, we have marked A to F all the points here. After that, mark this center also. Okay, from this reference line, take this center distance on the same projector line. This point as center, mark the new center here. It is O2. I will do. After marking center, mark apex also. Okay, so apex is also at the center, this distance. Take this distance from the center. Okay, so apex line, mark on the apex line. This is the apex. Here I am taking O3. I will take instead of O1, I will take O3. Okay, now these are all the points join all outer points with the continuous lines. Okay, what are the outer points? Here O3, F, E, D, C and B. Okay, these are the outer points. What are the inner points? A and O2. Okay, first join all outer points with the help of scale. O3 to F. Here if you are taking the axillary view, okay, here normally we have to take the hexagon, but I don't have this model of hexagon, just I am showing the pentagon pyramid. If you are taking the view, we can see the entire pentagon here. Similarly, we can see the entire hexagon here. So join A to B and A to F also. Here after this face we can see this edge also, okay, which is joining O to A. So join O to A. It is a slant edge. Make it dark. Now here whatever slant edges passing through these points to the apex, okay, other edges we can't see from this view, okay. So here these slant edges we can't see, okay, that's why join all these points with the apex with invisible lines. Invisible lines means dotted lines. Join initially this E to apex with the dotted line. Join D to apex. Join C to apex. This diagram is the auxiliary top view. This is the auxiliary plane. Okay. So this auxiliary plane is tilting 30 degrees to the reference line. So this is a reference line. This is tilting 30 degrees. So in this way we can do the auxiliary top view. Okay. Here mark the given dimension. Axis length is 70 mm. And then side of the hexagon is 30 mm. Always remember the main axillary view as well as this front view and top view should be in dark color compared to the projectile lines. Okay. Here also this projectile line should be in light color. Okay. Those are thin lines compared to the main diagrams. The other lectures of axillary views, I will give the video link in description box. Please check it. If you like this lecture, hit the like button, subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.